guys, today I want to show you how to make a romper using a onesie you already have. Here is the materials you're going to need for this project, but the most important thing is this elastic thread. You have to wind your bobbin by hand with elastic thread. So you want to wind it, but you don't want to pull too tight and you don't want it to be loose either. So just wind it until it's full, and you're probably going to have to do this a couple times throughout your project. Now we're going to start creating our pattern by taking our onesie that fits and opening it up. And I'm starting at the bottom middle and I'm going to trace the bottom. Then I'm going to trace the side, and I'm only doing one half because I'm going to cut this on the fold. Now I'm going to see how high I'm going to want my romper to come up, and I chose right here. I'm going to draw a straight line until I reach that point. And then find the center of my onesie and mark it. Now taking a ruler, I'm just going to straighten out the lines and connect them. Now I'm going to add my seam allowance to the top. I'm doing a half inch, so I'm just going to draw a half inch line above the one I traced. Then I'm measuring what my romper ended up measuring, and I'm going to double it to make my romper the bubble look that I'm going for. So I'm going to extend my romper by the same measurement I just got, which was 5. Also adding the seam allowance. I'm going to end up adding the 5 inches to the bottom too, but if you don't want the full bubble look at the bottom, you're just going to extend it about 2 inches and then draw a diagonal line from the bottom matching up to the top. Then you need to add your seam allowance to the bottom as well. I am doing a 1/2 inch seam allowance. Since I was going for the bubbled look, what I'm going to do is I'm going to extend the bottom. So I'm drawing a straight line down from the top to the bottom and then connecting it. And this will allow me to gather it later on. So now I'm just labeling my back piece that is going to be cut on the fold. Now we need to trace the front part. So I'm just going to tuck the back piece out of the way, lining it all up. And I'm going to put the front pattern piece onto my back pattern piece, just like that. And now I'm marking my seam allowance for the top part. So now I have my front pattern piece and my back pattern piece on one pattern. Now we need to see how big to make the strap. So go to that mark that you made earlier, how high you wanted your romper to go, and then measure up enough that you can tie it at the top. And then you need to measure your elastic for the bottom. I did this by just laying down the elastic like this. And now we have our pattern piece cut out, and I made notches so that I can fold it in the back when I'm cutting out the front pattern piece. Cut out a front, a back, 2 elastic, and 4 strap pieces. Start off by zigzag or serging the top edge of your rompers and fold them down 1/2 inch to your seam allowance and sew them. Sew your strap pieces right sides touching, so all the way around, leaving the bottom open to be able to turn them right side out later on. I'm creating a facing by putting my pattern piece down right sides touching and tracing it out. We need to finish off the top edge of these pieces and then place them right sides touching where they go on the front and back, and serge or zigzag stitch them down and along the bottom of this romper. Do this on both pieces. Here's what the pieces will look like when you turn them right side out. So you have your nice facings and you have your shoulder straps. Now we need to hem this up as well. So just fold that up and top stitch along the whole bottom of the front and back. I want to do 3.5 inches of shearing on my fabric. So I'm measuring that down on my fabric and drawing a line at 3.5 all the way across my front and my back. To make guides where I'm going to sew and follow the lines, I'm going to measure down 1/2 inch and draw a line all the way across and continue those lines until I reach 3.5 inches down. Now that we drew all our guidelines, we're going to adjust our settings on our machine, and I'm just adjusting my stitch length to the biggest stitch I can, which is 5.0. I'm going to replace my bobbin thread with my bobbin elastic thread that I wound earlier. Put that into my machine like normal, and keeping my regular thread on top. Now I'm going to start sewing, and all I'm going to do is sew like normal, following those lines from the top line all the way down until the last line. Sew all the way down your line until you reach the bottom. Then I'm going to stop, put my needle up, pivot my fabric and go down the other side following the next line. And I'm going to continue doing this until I reach the bottom line. Once all your shearing is done, it'll look like this. And it's not really looking that gathered right now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some steam from my iron and I'm gonna go over it. I actually press my iron down, which I don't think you're supposed to, but just run your steam over the top and it should shrink it some more. It actually looks like I need to play with my settings a little bit on my machine, so maybe adjust the tension too. I suggest just practicing and seeing what works best with your machine and your fabric. Since my shearing didn't shrink it down like I thought it was, what I'm gonna do is lay down my onesie once again and place my romper right on top. I'm gonna measure in how much needs to come off, which was about 2.5 inches for me. Then I'm just going to draw a line and sew a line from the top down to the bottom, just like this. I'm taking my elastic and I'm cutting it in half since I made these facings, and I'm gonna pin one side into the front facing and the other side into the back facing, and I'm going to stretch and zigzag as I go, and it will give you this look. Now I'm gonna lay down that onesie again and place my romper right on top, and we're going to find the placement for the straps. And then I'm going to place the straps to where I know they will fit perfectly onto the shoulder by using the onesie as a reference. Then I just sew it on the two fronts and the two backs and tied them at the shoulder. Place the snaps at the bottom and my romper was complete. I hope you guys liked this tutorial, and if you did, please give it a big thumbs up. And if you like my channel, please subscribe. I would love to have you. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Oh,